one bombshell incident for me is Stephenville, Texas, where this person, Margie Galvez, is, this is outside of Stephenville, close to Dublin, Texas. There is a predator who is stalking her game, her chickens, her ducks, or whatever, right? Eating them up. What's causing this? Why is my game missing? Who's in my backyard? So she decides she's going to catch the culprit. She doesn't know what it is, a coyote, fox, she doesn't know. So she sets up a night vision camera in her backyard, going on at like midnight, one in the morning, midnight, to see what was out there. Around Thanksgiving of 2007, Stephenville happens in January 2008, I think. Around 2007, she catches this beam of something. I'm going to say it turns up as light on a camera, but since this is an infrared camera, this is a night vision camera, what night vision cameras do is they measure the temperature differential between the object, between an object, and the background ambient temperature. So what turns up as light is heat, okay? And she sees this beam, this cone-shaped beam, aimed from something out of frame, out of camera frame, towards the ground, but not hitting the ground. Hello, what does that mean? It's not hitting the ground. Sweeps back and forth, and then snaps up again. She's blown away. I don't know what it is. Folks who want to see the video, go to the DVD, the Stephenville episode, you'll see the video for yourself. In other words, I'm not making this up. What I'm saying is, don't take my word for it. See the video with your own eyes and you explain it. Then we talked to another witness who remains nameless because she begged us not to use her name. We didn't on the show and I'm not going to use it now. But it is a witness. You can see what she drew. Again, it's on the DVD. You can see this, her drawing of the object she saw hovering over a railroad track outside of Stephenville, flashing a beam. And she said it's light. And then it didn't hit the ground and snapped up again. So she saw the object that she said flashed the beam. So we have two corroborating witnesses, triangular shape, and a series of what he said were windows. They could be anything, but lights along the rear of it. So it's triangular, so it's a V shape. Moving forward is a V, but along the base of the triangle, it had a series of lights. And that's been corroborated by five or six witnesses in this whole series, in this one particular incident across three states. Michigan, Ohio, and Missouri.
Wow.
Right. So you've got Phoenix, you've got Stephenville, Texas. And again, these are like 10 years apart, Stephenville, Texas. Then you have the Michigan sightings from, I think it's 2005. I'm not sure the dates now. It's been so long. Then you have the sightings in Bucks County, Pennsylvania in 2008. And again, this is an incredible story of same thing. This woman in Levittown, Pennsylvania sees a craft. She believes it is, she says it's got the light like a star, but it gets lower and lower. And it's a series of lights. And this thing is flashing some kind of a crazy beam over her backyard. And then it seems to hover over a tree. And it snaps this beam on the tree. And in the beam, she's standing there, she's watching it. And she has missing time, but it's not missing time. She doesn't claim to be abducted. She's saying, I just lost track of time completely. She sees these flakes, almost like snowflakes inside a beam, a description I've heard on 10 different occasions. Snowflakes over this tree. The beam snaps up, the object goes away. The next morning, the part of the tree where the beam hit is dead. Why did it die? Old age. It was simply died of old age. And a robin that was in the tree, a young robin, is lying dead on the ground of old age. The rest of the tree is fine.
Wow.
So the very recurring cases for me.
Amazing. USOs, fascinating, because I've talked to some people who just think that it's more in the sky or that it's landing on the ground, but don't believe so much in the collaborative concept of these submerge under sea bases, but I've talked to others that do. I wanted to get your opinion. You've explored this, obviously, on your show. Do you have a definitive opinion on that, or do you believe that that UFOs could be under the water at any point, either just exploring and or, you know, just that whole topic? What is your opinion on that?
Well, my guess is that, first of all, the fact that before the age of television, before the age of any technology, really, Christopher Columbus in his log writes about a UFO is to me very compelling. Officers of the watch saw bright lights under the water near the Santa Maria that left the water and went into the sky. That's in the log. So that's a very important witness to me, because even in those days, your officers of the watch, before there was radar, before there was night vision, before a lot, you really had to rely on your officers of the watch to be the eyes and ears of the ship. And here's an officer of the watch saying that, and making entry in a log, that this light left the water and went into the sky. I've spoken to so many eyewitnesses down in, for example, in Panama City, who said, these witnesses said that they saw, at least one was a sailboat captain, who said that this craft was under my sailboat and then flew up into the sky.